Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I have part one of a massive book haul. My local town hall hosted the annual book sale, which ran over the 8th and the 9th of September. I went back on both days and I came away with way too many books. I'm just going to show you what I hauled. I won't go into detailed descriptions or we might be here for years. So, without further ado, these are in no particular order, they're in no particular genre, they're just however my pile came up to the desk. So let's just jump in, shall we? The first book is The Cranford Chronicles by Elizabeth Gaskell. This contains both Cranford and the second book, which is My Lady Ludlow. Technical difficulty there, I just bumped the tripod, so if I'm in a slightly different spot, I apologise for that. Okay. Next we have the Complete Brothers Grimm Fairy Tales. Thanks to Kate Howe's recommendations on her channel, I now have a omnibus of James Herriot Vet stories. Mary Poppins She Wrote by Valerie Lawson. This is a biography of the Australian author P.L. Travers, who wrote, obviously, the Mary Poppins series. Since I plan to read the series when I can get my hands on some of them, I've been picking them up here and there, and I found Anthony Trollope's Phineas Finn from the Palliser novels. Edith Wharton, The Buccaneers. Apparently this was turned into a BBC adaptation. I've never seen the adaptation, never heard of it, never heard of the book, but I have now. Love in the Time of Cholera by Gabriel Garcia Marquez. E.M. Forster's A Passage to India. Amazingly, I found a Stephen King book, and this is 4 Past Midnight in this lovely, big, massive, floppy edition. So I'm going to have fun reading The Langoliers and Secret Window, Secret Garden, as well as, I think, The Librarian is in here and The Sun Dog, I think it is. Anyway, I shall be getting to these soon. They Came to Baghdad, Agatha Christie's Cat Amongst the Pigeons, Nao Marsh, Black as He's Painted, with this lovely, creepy black cat. Thanks to Emmerich, the Bookish Princess, I can now add Dorothy L. Sayers' Gaudy Nights to my ever-increasing TBR pile. Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I just picked this up because it is an alternate cover and I do like to find little old paperback editions of Pride and Prejudice. War of the Worlds by H.G. Wells. The Truth by Terry Pratchett. This is the 25th Discworld novel and the Discworld now has a newspaper. Hearts in Atlantis by Stephen King. I only found 2 Berkeley Prime Crimes on the first day, and that was The Hunter's Tale by Margaret Fraser. This is part of a medieval series. Blessed is the Busybody by Emily Richards. This is the first book in her Ministry is Murder series. The lovely big Mary Poppins omnibus. Inda by Sherwood Smith. One of my favourite finds from Saturday was the bind-up of Douglas Adams' Dirk Gently series, and this is Dirk Gently, Holistic Detective Agency, and The Long Dark Tea Time of the Soul. Now we come to the older books that I managed to find. The first one is Paul Gallico, Mrs. Harris Goes to New York, Christabel's Cornish Adventures by D.M. Hardy, Dorothy May Hardy, volumes 1 and 2 of this old Everyman Library edition of Don Quixote by Miguel de Cervantes. These are only very small, and they've got interesting illustrations on the front. They're a little bit sun faded, but that's okay. I now have Don Quixote, so I can eventually get on with my read of it. And finally, I found this really old, gorgeous copy of The Wild Swan in this beautiful edition, Hans Christian Andersen Fairy Tales, and I thought the plate on the front was just so gorgeous, and it's very old, and I opened it up thinking, oh, there'll be such gorgeous illustrations in this, and somebody's child has coloured in every picture with crayons. Doesn't matter which small little picture you come across, it's covered in crayon, but it's a gorgeous little book, so I'm not too mad at it. And finally, we come to my favourite 3 finds from the day. The first one is just a trade paperback, but it is the lovely edition of American Gods by Neil Gaiman in this beautiful green highway scene. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. I've been admiring this for years online and I'm actually surprised to find a copy at my local book sale. And finally, I scored 2 folio volumes. This one here, in its little pretty, very pale pink cover, is a 1979 edition of Dangerous Liaisons, and it is absolutely in A1 condition. The pages are so well preserved, the images are beautiful, and this is just a really good quality book. I haven't really had anything to do with folio editions before. I'm just trying to find you a nice picture. There we go. There's another one. And they are just, it's absolutely gorgeous. So I'm so happy to have that. And my absolute find of the weekend was this gorgeous big folio 3-volume set. And I can hear you saying, why aren't you showing us what it is? Well, it is the, I think it's the 1992 edition, first edition of Mervyn Peake's Gormenghast trilogy. And the spines caught my attention. It was sitting on the desk face up and I snapped it before anybody else could get to it. And these editions are just absolutely gorgeous. We have Titus Groan with this lovely ink work cover, all the cross hatching, and it is just beautiful. These are in such good condition. And the whole book is just full of illustrations like this. And I couldn't believe it. I've got a ratty old paperback somewhere and I've been wanting to replace it, and this just fell into my lap. So, and this one is volume 2, Gormenghast, if you can see it through the glare. And it also has an absolutely gorgeous wraparound cover. And the artwork in this is also in the same vein. It's just stunning. And book the third is Titus Alone. And this one has a beautiful wraparound as well. And this one, they're all in excellent condition. There's nothing wrong with any of them. And this one, of course, is full of illustrations like this. But I can hear you ask, how much did you have to part with to take this home? I walked away with this for $3. Thank you very much. Yeah, so that was my day one of the book sale. I will film later on part two because I couldn't carry all the books in and I couldn't even fit them all on my little desk. So I will be breaking the adventure of the book sale up into two parts, I think. Until I catch you in the next part, happy reading!